हेलो क्लास सिक्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड एट योर होम। स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू ऑल नो, योर एग्जाम्स आर कमेंसिंग फ्रॉम 14th ऑफ दिस मंथ, 14th दिसंबर, एंड द सिलेबस विल बी फ्रॉम असाइनमेंट 15th टू 25। यू हैव डन चैप्टर ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड, लेसन नंबर 3A, वाटर बॉडीज, Seas and oceans, lesson number 3B, water bodies, lakes and rivers, and lesson number 4, agriculture. Also, you have done map work, continents, oceans, and important seas of the world. Okay, these will be your syllabus for your second term exams. This time, this exam, you will have descriptive type of questions. You have to do descriptive type of questions where you have to learn all the definitions, short answers and long answers also. Okay, then assignments, you will get 25 marks for your assignments. Till today, how many assignments you got? 25, then you will get out of 25 the number of assignments you send. I will give you marks according to them. Okay, 40 marks for your second term exam, written exam, and 25 marks for your assignments. So I want you all to send assignments regularly and on time. Rainwater harvesting. Rainwater, what is rainwater harvesting? Rainwater harvesting is a technique or strategy for the collection of rainwater and storing it in the right way for future use. And the water can be used for future. Now, importance of rainwater harvesting. Why rainwater harvesting is important, or why this is need for current time? Okay, rainwater harvesting can provide an independent water source in areas where other water sources are unavailable. Number two, it helps to reduce peak demands during summer months. Number third, rainwater can be used for irrigation, household uses, etc. Like we for storing rainwater, we have to dig a pit in the form of pit, well, dams. The rainwater can be collected. Now, River Yangtze. River Yangtze, where does it flow? In China. It flows in China. The Yangtze is the third longest river. The Yangtze is the third longest. Nile, the longest river. The river Amazon, the second longest, and the third longest is River Yangtze. The Yangtze flows through nine provinces of China, through nine provinces, through nine states. Third, the river has served as a means of transportation for 2000 years. For the last 2000 years, this river is used as a means of transportation. Okay, now fourth one, the large plain formed by the river. The large plain formed by the river is known for rice production. Now, River Huanghe. The Huanghe is the sixth longest river at 3,395 miles. This river travels 3,395 miles. The river is called the Yellow River because of the silt which it brings. Okay. Now, third, the earliest civilization of China settled on the banks of the Huanghe. That's why the civilization was called Huanghe civilization, because of this river only, Huanghe. Now fourth one, the river had flooded so often. Every year the situation of flood occur there in that region. That's why it is known as this river is known as the River of Sorrow. The Murray Darling River. These two rivers flow in Australia. The Murray Darling are the major rivers of Australia. A large amount of species can be found living in the river basin. Number three, Murray Darling Basin contributes significantly to Australian food and fiber production because the region is fertile. That's why it contributes significantly to Australian food and fiber production. Now, Murray Darling begin far inland and flow to the Southern Ocean. Murray Darling drainage area is one of the largest in the world and certainly the largest on the continent, draining most of the inland Victoria, New South Wales and Southern Queensland. River Rhine flows in Europe. Okay, the Rhine River runs through the most populated part of Europe. It is most populated part of Europe. Second, it is also the busiest waterway in Europe. Which river? River Rhine. Now River Obi. Obi is one of the major river of Asia and flows through Central Asia, Central Russia. The river begins its journey from the Altai Mountains. It means this river originates from Altai Mountains and flows through Siberia to the Gulf of Obi. That's why the river is frozen for 5 to 6 months. Now, causes of the water, causes of pollution of water bodies. Water bodies, the contamination of water bodies like rivers, lakes, seas, etc. is called water pollution. Rapid growth of population, urbanization and industrialization are the major source of water pollution. Rapid industrialization, this paragraph will help you while giving answer 9. Okay, rapid industrialization generate wide range of waste which ultimately joins the water bodies. Major industries that contribute to the water pollution are paper, chemical, leather, textile. Wastage of these industries are drained into water bodies. That's why they are the causes of water pollution. Okay. Now, domestic sewage containing the detergents and other pollutants in many cases joins some water body like river, lake, etc. Detergents can have poisonous effect in all types of aquatic life if they are present in sufficient quantities, and this include the biodegradable detergents. In effort in agriculture, this paragraph will help you when you do answer 10. Okay. In an effort to increase the agricultural production, farmers use a variety of chemicals in the form of fertilizers. Variety of chemicals are also used to kill the unwanted pests and insects. Such chemicals are washed off by runoff and carried to the nearest stream, which gets polluted. Farm and animal wastes cause bad odor and pollute the water when they are discharged into it. Okay. The meaning of distributary, I have told you earlier, when the large river, for example, a large river is flowing over there, main river, and it splits over there, then distributary is this. Like another river is, if join this river, this main river will be called what? The tributary. Okay, this way the main river this river is joined by another river. This is called what? Tributary. Okay, this is called tributary. Tributary is a river. A tributary is a smaller river or a stream that joins a larger river. Tributary is a smaller river that joins a larger river. Okay, this is the difference between tributary and distributary. That's all for the day. Do well in exam. Everything whichever you have done between assignment 15 to 25, they will be coming in your exam. Okay, and do well in exam. Best of luck. Thank you. Bye bye.